Welcome to all students in finite element analysis. Today we discuss about general FEM procedure. The solution of general problem by the finite element method follows an ordinary step-by-step procedure. With reference to the static structural problem, the step-by-step procedure is as follows. Step 1, to discretization of the given content. The first step in FEM is to divide the given content in the small regions called the finite elements. The analysis is carried out for each of these elements. The points where properties are to be determined for an element are called nodes. The process of discretization of containment is very simple. Second step is selection of displacement model. For the continuum, discretize into number of smaller elements and the displacement variation over each of the element is unknown. Hence, a displacement function is required to assume for each of these elements known as displacement model. There are two kinds of displacement function, that is, could be assumed: polynomial displacement function and trigonometric displacement function. Out of the above two functions, one that is preferred for APA is polynomial functions for its mathematical calculations. After this, there is type and order of functions. In step 3, derivation of element matrices and load vectors. The element stiffness matrix and load vector for which element are derived using various methods such as direct method and potential energy method. The equilibrium equation for an element is given as K equivalent into K equivalent equal to F raised to E equivalent. After this, step number 4 is assemble of element equations to obtain global equilibrium equations. As the continuum is composed of several finite elements, the individual element stiffness matrix, displacement and load vectors are assembled to obtain the global equilibrium equation. The global equilibrium equation is K into Q equal to F, where K is the global stiffness matrix, Q is the global stiffness vector, F is the global force vector. In step number 5, there is applications of boundary conditions. Various boundary conditions are imposed prior to solution the problem to obtain a non-singular solution. There are three methods of applying boundary conditions for APA problem. That is, elimination method, penalty method and multipoint constraint method. In step 6, to determine the unknown parameters, after imposing the boundary conditions to be global equilibrium equations, unknown parameters such as nodal displacement, element strengths and stresses can be obtained. There are some methods like discretization of given continuum, selection of displacement model, find element stiffness matrix, assemble of global stiffness matrix, apply boundary conditions, determine unknown parameters. So these are the steps of FEA. In general procedure for finite element analysis is pre-processing. Define the geometric domain of the problem, define the element times to be used, define the material properties, define the geometric properties of the element, define the element connectivities, define the physical constraints, define the loadings. In solution, compute the unknown values of the primary field variables. Computed values are then used by back substitution to be compute additional derived variables, reaction forces, element stresses and heat flow. In post-processing, the post-processor software contains sophisticated routines used for sorting, printing and plotting selected results from finite element solutions. Now is the stiffness matrix. The primary characteristics of a finite element are embedded in the element stiffness matrix. For a structure finite element, the stiffness matrix contains the geometric and material behavior information that indicates the resistance of the element to deformation when subjected to loading. Such deformation may include axial bending, shear and torsional effects. For finite elements used in non-structure analysis, such as fluid flow and heat transfer, the term stiffness matrix is also used. Since the matrix represents the resistance of the element to change when subjected to external influences in linear spring as a finite element. This is a spring. A linear elastic spring is a mechanical device capable of supporting axial loading, and the elongation and contraction of spring is directly proportional, or spring stiffness K. This is a spring. There is K, displacement U1, U2, forces F1, F2. This is a linear spring element with nodes, nodal displacement and nodal forces, and this is load deflection curve. Assuming that both the nodal displacements are zero, when the spring is undeformed, the net spring deformation is given by del is equal to U2 minus U1. F is equal to K into del, that is K into U2 minus U1. This is the equation K equivalent to U equal to F. This is the stiffness matrix, K equivalent equal to K minus K minus KK. This is the stiffness matrix for one spring elements. This is the F is equal to K into X. This is the unknown. 2 by 2 matrix. 2 nodal displacement are degree of freedom, and 2 displacement are not independent, that is the body in continuous and elastic. Therefore, the matrix is symmetric. Also, the matrix is singular and therefore not invertible. That is because the problem is defined is incomplete and does not have a solution. Boundary conditions are required. So after this is we already discussed. Boundary conditions are required. This is the in figure systems of two springs, that is K1, K2, displacement U1, U2, forces F1, F3 and F2 is shown. This is the free body diagram of this diagram. Writing the equation, this is the equation K1 minus, this is for two springs. To being assembly, the equilibrium equation describes the behavior of the system of two springs. The displacement, that is compatibility conditions, which relate element displacements to system displacement are written as, this is system displacements are written as, U1 is equal to U1, U2 is equal to U2, U1 equal to U2, U2. And therefore K1 minus K1 minus K1 K1 U1 U2 F1 1 F2 1, this is the equation. Expand each equation in matrix form K1 minus K1 0 minus K1 K1 0 0 0 U1 U2 0 F1 F2 0. This is the member. Note that the system stiffness matrix is symmetric, as is the case with all linear systems referred to orthogonal coordinate systems. In singular, since no constraints are applied to prevent rigid body motion of the system matrix is simply a superposition of the individual element stiffness matrices with proper assignment of element nodal displacement and associated stiffness coefficient to system nodal displacements. This is the APA for multiple mini element. This is F into K into U. This is the example of boundary condition. So today we discuss about general APM procedure. So thanks all of you.